Started. Now let's start the event binding, which is today's topic. So let's start the event binding. So to demonstrate event binding, what I'm going to do is, let me add one component. So as discussed, let me add a login component. Okay. So ng g for generate component login. Right. So what it says is
PowerShell खुला होगा
आपका नहीं PowerShell यहाँ से
PowerShell है सर command secret
जब मैं यहाँ से कोई terminal add करता हूँ तो वो यहाँ पर जब मैं यहाँ से plus करता हूँ तो मैं terminal add करता हूँ right तो What happens is, यहाँ से मेरा disable किया क्योंकि मेरा path जो मेरा execute path होता है starting का वो ठीक से set नहीं है तो अगर किसी को ऐसी problem आती है right तो हमारे पास other options भी हैं we have other options as well so इसीलिए मैं क्या करता हूँ मैं git install करके रखता हूँ और git का git bash जो है वो बहुत strong होता है मतलब उसमें इस तरह की permissions या path set करने के issues नहीं आते हैं सो जैसे मैं अभी तक आपको दिखा रहा था डेमोस्ट्रेट कर रहा था प्रीवियस यू नो सेशंस में भी सो लेट मी जस्ट यूज दैट इफ यू आर फेसिंग प्रॉब्लम देन यू डू इट अदरवाइज कीप यूजिंग योर पावरशेल ओनली और कीप यूजिंग योर टर्मिनल ओनली सो आई गो टू डेस्कटॉप सी ड्राइव ट्रेनिंग बेसिक पाथ या गिट बैश या फिर कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट आप वो भी खोल सकते हो कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट भी खोल सकते हो फ्रॉम हियर इफ आई से एनजीजी कंपोनेंट लॉगिन Okay, so it says one login component got added. Okay, so check करते हैं कहाँ पर add हुआ है. Yeah, so login got added, correct? अब मुझे login component को run करना. I need to run login component. So how I will be adding the login component? मैं इसे कैसे execute करूँ? Because as of now, my login component will not work. So what I need to do to make sure that this will work? इसे कहाँ ऐड करूँ मैं? Any idea, team?
Sir,
app.html.
Exactly. I'll go to first of all just check what is the selector name. Obviously, it will say app-login. So go to your app-component.html and again comment it. And use app login. Now, if you see the browser, it will refresh to login. Okay. So now, if you right click, and see inspect element. Okay, and check the DOM. DOM is document object model. This whole HTML page what loads in the browser is called DOM, Document Object Model. तो अगर इसको expand करोगे तो देखो पहले app root आया. App root के अंदर आपने क्या call किया? What we have called? Login. So login आ गया. Right? तो देखो element, component के अंदर component. App component is my parent component. So app root got loaded because we called it in index page. And then this login component we called in app component. So this login is inside the app component. See? ये clear है इतना? Are we good? Team?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's finish it quickly. One second. Now let's go back to our application. Let's go back to login page And again, let me just explain you what we are doing. So we are doing event binding. What is event binding? So you have some events on the HTML page. Now you want to post the data. You have some data on the HTML page. You wanted to post the data back to your class file, correct? You want to post the data back to your class file. So which event you will be using here? Team, you have a login page, click. You have a login button, correct? So you will be using click event. Do you all agree?
Yes.
Do you all agree? Okay, good. So like this, if let's say you wanted to show the tooltip, you know what is tooltip? Tooltip?
Like, yes.
This is tooltip.
Login page.
Correct, exactly. Can you see the tooltip now? This is tooltip. Tooltip. Let's say you wanted to show the tooltip like this. So what event you will be using?
Hover.
So when you use any event to perform some action, that is called event binding. You got my point?
Yes.
Right. So let's quickly build a login page. So for login page, what do you need? A table. In a table, you have TR. In the TR, you have TD. In the TD, you will be saying username. Do you all agree? Second table data would be the input text box. Right, team? So one row is done. Let's save. Let's save and see parallelly. One second. Yeah. So let's add another row. Say TR. In the TR, again, I will add TD. Say password. In next TD, next column, I will say input. This time, input type would be password. Correct? Save. Now you see one more row got added, correct? Now what else is required? What else is required, team?
Button.
Button. So here I say login. Let the button also come, login. So your login page is done. This is a simple HTML login page. Now you want to apply a click event. Okay. So now think and then answer me, correctly. And I need answer from all of you, okay? You tell me one thing. Now I need a click functionality, correct? So what I will be using now? So when I need loop functionality, I use ng for. When I need hidden functionality, I use hidden, Then when I wanted to use any other functionality, so I have an inbuilt functionality to, use it. I mean, I have inbuilt functionality for that in Android. So now
one click name,
correct. But what does it call? What does it call? What I need?
Sir, ng on click.
NG.
I'm not talking about ng on click and all. What I'm saying is, listen to my question first. No, I need a click functionality. I'm telling you, I need a click functionality. So I need a click functionality, which is Angular should be having a ready-made functionality for it. So I'm saying, what that functionality called?
Directive.
What I need is directive. Whenever you need. Any functionality, correct? 99.9% you will be having a ready-made directive for it, correct? Did we discuss about directive or not in last to last session? We discussed about the directive.
Yes, sir.
In last session also we discussed about the directive, right? Directives are what? Directives are basically inbuilt functionality. So for all the functionality that you see, like click, hover, hover out, blur, correct? I mean, all the attribute based directive. For most of the thing, you already have the directive in Angular. You just need to call it. Okay. But in case you need some, you know, functionality which is not there, you need some functionality to be used in your HTML, and it is not there. Then what you'll do?
We will write, or
we will create our own directive that we call custom directive. Do you all agree and understand this point or not?
Yes.
No. I am saying everyone. Do you all understand? अगर Angular के पास inbuilt functionality नहीं है, तो हम खुद वो functionality बनाएंगे. So we call this process inbuilt function custom directive. Okay. So अभी तो हमारे पास हमको click चाहिए and we have the click. So what I will do is I say click. So click is basically a directive in Angular. Okay. So click equals to, now I need to write my own function. Say login handler. Lekin login handler se bhi kaam nahi banega. Let's go back to the TS file. And let's create this function over here. Right? अब मैं यहाँ से alert लिखता हूँ, यहाँ पर simple alert. और ये देखता हूँ कि ये print हो रहा है कि नहीं हो रहा है, right? So I say hi all, you clicked me. Correct? मैंने इतना लिखा अभी. ये समझ में आया? Did you get this? ये मेरा click directive है. And click directive में मुझे अपना function call करना है. Obviously this function has to be there in my class, so I declared it and define it as well. So function definition mein maine koi logic nahi likha, simple alert print kiya. Itna sabko clear hai? Do you all agree on this?
Yes.
And I say all means all. Any doubt please ask me now only, please. Team, is it clear? Okay, let's proceed. Let's see, will this work or not? अब मैं क्लिक करता हूँ लॉगिन पर. सो यस, इट इज सेइंग हाय ऑल यू क्लिक्ड मी, हाय ऑल यू क्लिक्ड मी. बट मुझे तो ऐसा नहीं चाहिए ना. व्हाट आई नीड इज आई नीड यूजर नेम एंड पासवर्ड, करेक्ट? आई नीड टू पास माय यूजर नेम एंड पासवर्ड, करेक्ट, इन दिस फंक्शन, करेक्ट टीम?
यस.
ओके, सो let's do one thing. Let's pass these values. So how I will be passing it? Let's say if I pass one second. If I pass Ajay and the password, if I pass Ajay at the 123. So like this, I have passed the value, but this is hard coded. But first of all, check step by step. First of all, check when I pass any value, is it taking it or not? So in my login handler function, I pass Ajay. Ajay means, let's say I'm talking about username, and Ajay at the 123, I'm talking about the password. So in the login also, I'm taking the same thing. I say, I'm expecting a username, which is of string type. And I'm expecting a PWD means password, which is of string type. So can you just tell me what are these two, which I declared here?
Arguments,
correct?
Arguments.
So arguments or input parameter, correct?
Yes.
So I can simply, say U and P also, correct? No problem in that, because these are arguments and it can be anything, right? So U and P means username and password. And now let's print this U and P, U comma P. Plus, I need to concatenate it in plus single code, स्पेस. अंडरस्टूड टीम? डज इट मेक सेंस और नॉट? इन अलर्ट, इन अलर्ट आई टुक दिस यू एंड पी डायनेमिकली हियर. ओके, राइट क्लिक एंड फॉर्मेट. की फॉर्मेटिंग योर योर पेज सो दैट इट विल बी वेल फॉर्मेटेड. ओके, let's save and see in the browser. So now I click on login. So it says, hi all, you clicked me Ajay and the password Ajay@123. So which means my function is also working and function arguments are also working, means function input parameters are also working, but still this is hard coded, this is not dynamic. I want dynamic, right team? I want dynamic. So now let's see the next step. Let me just, you know, copy and comment this. How you comment a HTML page? How you comment a HTML tag? Let me just
go plus backslash.
See, I'm just repeating it. So let me first of all show you the uncomment. Control plus KU is uncomment. Control plus KC is comment. You select that line, select those lines, right? Control plus KU is uncomment. Control plus KC is comment. KC, control plus KC is comment. Control plus KU is uncomment. Okay. And let me write one more time button. And here I want to pass the, you know, values dynamically. So let's see how you can, you know, bind a form or pass the value from your HTML to class. So I will go to my input parameter and here I will create one template variable. Okay, template variable. So I will call it say username, and similarly I will create one more template variable, say hash pwt for example. Okay, let's make it a little small, say username and pwt. These are my two template variable. Now I go back, okay, in Angular. This is only available in Angular, not in HTML. So in Angular, we can create a template variable and then we can take the value of my template, correct? I can pass the value of my template in my code behind file or class file. How? Let's see. So here I am saying una dot value, because in text box, what we have? There is one of the attribute of text box called value. So in text box we have value. Similarly, we have another text box for password. So I say pwd dot value. Save it. And now I am passing the value dynamically. Right? Una dot value and pwd dot value. So una value will go into u and pwd value will go into p. And that's how whatever we pass dynamically, it will print here. Let's see will this happen or not. So as of now, some autofill form, you know, autofill happened. So some previous value got automatically printed. So let's see. Let's try with this only. Login. See, it is saying this is your username and this is your password. And let me just change it. I say, I fill something else. Say, I fill this 7077 like this, mobile number and password. I say, admin@123 login. Now you see admin@123 and you have this as username, correct? So this is your complete event binding, where you are passing the value or binding the value from your HTML right to your class file. Now with this technique, can't you take any value from your form or from your HTML back to your class file? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Let me just go one step ahead and add just before the button. Let me add one more TR. Okay, terms and condition. So I say TD and say I agree. Although these things are there in sign up, not in login, but I'm just trying to replicate something like this. I agree with terms and conditions. Okay, this is a text, an actual, sorry, this is a text, an actual checkbox will be here. So I say input checkbox. Okay, so here also in the checkbox, ADU. I didn't understand. Okay, radio button. But radio button is like I need to say male, female, right? Cash or credit.
Yeah.
A saving or current account like this. But here it is one checkbox, one single control I need, right? Where I need to just say true, false, check on, check off, something like that. So checkbox is the right choice for that. So I'm again creating a template variable, say TN. Terms and condition, TNC, terms and condition, okay? Hash TNC. So now you tell me, I want you to scratch your head and tell me, now here what I should take? TNC dot what? Because value is in the text box only. For checkbox, there is no value.
Completed.
No, try. So
true
for text box, no. For text box, we have the, For text box, we have the attribute called value to take the value because there is some value attribute in the text box and we are taking it. But in the case of checkbox, there is no value attribute. So what we are think what we are doing on the checkbox. What
check
exactly?
Checked.
Correct. So right thing is checked. Okay. Checked. So I need to check. I need to get the checked property. Is it true or false? I need to get checked property of my checkbox. Is it true or false? So let's see now. Okay. Again, I need to have it over here. Of course, without that, it will not work, right? So here I will add one more argument. Say TNC, I'll take as it is TNC and it should be Boolean. Correct now? Either true or false. So same thing after paragraph. After P tag, what I'm saying. Plus single quote, space. Then I say plus. TNC. Okay. Okay. Let's see. Let's run and see. So if I don't pass anything and say login, so now it's saying false. Did you see that? It's saying false. Because I have not checked it. It's not checked. Now, if I go ahead and change, let's say the username and password, and now I click on this, and then I say login. So what it says? What it says? True. Team, is it clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Good.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. Very good. So what next? So this is your dynamic form building, or not dynamic form building, my mistake, sorry. This is called your event binding. So you have binded your event, correct, in your code behind file, in your class file, and you are successfully able to pass the value from your HTML back to your class file. And now you can do anything. What you can do here, you will be of course calling the API, right, passing the username, password. API will hit the DB, check the username password. If it is correct, it will come back and say, login successfully. If it is false, so it will give you the error that, incorrect username and password. Team, you got my point?
Yes.
Okay. What else now?
Are these template variables?
Correct. These are template variables.
Are part of HTML or
no, it's part of Angular.
Okay, like if we use JavaScript or something, we cannot use this type of template variable.
No, never.
Okay.
Now, let's add one more event. Okay. So, what I say is, hold on, 1 minute. What else, what other event you wanted to check? You tell me.
Over.
Why
sir, would, capture.
Why not? No, captcha is something too much for now. And for captcha, you know, we need to integrate Google captcha. So that's not a feasible thing to do as of now for first session. How about checking the validation? Don't you think validation should also be part of this? Although Angular has a validation, but let's say you wanted to check something. Say you have a search text box and you wanted to capture that what I have written should go to my code behind file. Search, Google search. Just like Google search, right? So what I do is, let me minimize this table. And this was, say, example of login page. And let's say I want to apply. Before search, if I show you something on the form, what else I can show? Hold on. If I, let's say, go to my checkbox and start typing something, right? And if it is, let's say, not, if it is not number, so it should tell me, it should give me some error message. Okay, let's try to check this. Now you tell me, I wanted to think and then answer. I wanted to have a functionality where I type something here and it should trigger. So what functionality are you looking for? The moment I type something here, it should trigger. So which functionality I'm talking
about?
Of course, directive, but which directive now? Any idea? I know you don't know. So first of all, we need a directive. Do you all agree? We need a functionality in the HTML, in the HTML, because in the TS, we can create our own functionality. That's not a problem. But in TS, in HTML, we need to use directives basically for the predefined functionality. Okay. And if predefined functionality is not there in HTML, we will create custom directive. Otherwise, we should use all the inbuilt directive for any functionality in HTML. Please do remember this. So what I need is, I need a directive. But which directive? I am doing the key press. Do you all agree or not? Key press.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
I say text change handler. This is my user defined function, text change handler. And again, I would say, if you type something, I mean, if something is, let me first of all hook it with TS. So this is my text change handler here. And again, I say console log, say you are typing something. Correct? Is this much clear? Key press directive. Key press event directive. I added my handler, function handler, and define my function handler, declare and define my function handler in my TS file, class file. Correct. Let's see, will this work or not? And to check this, is it working or not? What I will do is, I will open the console log also, because there only we are showing. I will remove, and then in the console, open inspect element and click console. In the console, you write something. See? Correct? Whatever number of keystroke I'm doing, it is capturing. Right, team?
Yes.
Correct? So on that note, let me just pass the data dynamically. How? Same thing. UNA dot value. Does it make sense?
Yes, sir.
Team, is it going okay, or it is going fast, or you are understanding, not understanding? Please tell me.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
We are getting it.
All of you? Mukta, Ayush, Arjun.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I pass an argument. So I should receive an argument here. So again, I say you string. Right. And instead of you are typing, I would say. Say you. Correct. So whatever you type, it will print over here. Let's see again here. Versus. Okay. I have not saved it. I have not saved my HTML. Saved my HTML now. Come back here. I say whatever I will type, correct? Whatever I will type, it will take my keystrokes. Did you see that? Correct?
Yes, sir.
So this is one more, you know, event I have associated. Key press. Okay, key press. Okay, let's see, you know, one more event.
Sir, what if copy text from another text file to this input field, then it will console that value?
What, repeat it again. What if?
सर अगर किसी टेक्स्ट फाइल से, मतलब मान लो कि मैं google.com कहीं से कॉपी करके लाता हूं और इसे इनपुट टेक्स्ट फाइल में पेस्ट कर देता हूं, तो क्या वो कंसोल में जाएगा या फिर हम उस मतलब उसको कैसे कंसोल में देखेंगे?
लेट्स सी, अगर मैं सपोज यही ऊपर से उठाता हूं और यहां पेस्ट कर देता हूं,
यस
ये बोल रहे हो ना?
यस सर
हां, तो ये कॉपी पेस्ट पे नहीं आ रहा है, तो मैं क्या करूंगा, जो पेस्ट का जो स्काई कोड होता है ना, स्काई कोड जैसे एंटर का स्काई कोड होता है, राइट? आई विल टेक द स्काई कोड, की प्रेस, आई मीन आई की ऑन की प्रेस, आई विल टेक व्हाट की हैज बीन हिट, इज इट एंटर और स्पेस और स्किप और कंट्रोल वी मीन पेस्ट, व्हाट की हैज बीन हिट, सो इफ द की हैज बीन हिट देन आई विल कंसोल. एज ऑफ नाउ इट इज हिटिंग ओनली ऑन की प्रेस, द मोमेंट यू प्रेस एनी की लाइक दिस, राइट? This you can try by yourself. If you're still not able to get it, I'll tell you. You got my point, what I'm saying?
Yes.
Or no?
Got it.
Mouse enter. I say mouse hover handler. Okay. Mouse hover handler. And let me add mouse over here. And again, I say console.log. Hovered at me. I'm just explaining you some you know, events which you can apply. So mouse enter, mouse leave, mouse out, one second, mouse enter, mouse leave, I guess leave. See, mouse enter and mouse leave. So the moment I say mouse enter, no, neither mouse enter working nor mouse leave working. Okay, did I put it wrong? Mouse enter, mouse enter is like this only. What is the change here? This is mouse enter only. Mouse spelling correct? Mouse इंटर और माउस ओवर या फाइल इज नॉट सेव्ड. सी होवर एंड द मोमेंट आई से आउट इट इज होवर आउट राइट होवर आउट होवर आउट करेक्ट राइट टीम.
यस यस सर.
ओके नाउ लेट्स सी वन स्टेप अहेड. ओके लेट्स सी वन स्टेप अहेड. नाउ यू टेल मी व्हाट इफ व्हेन आई होवर ऑन टेक्स्ट बॉक्स करेक्ट व्हेन आई होवर ऑन टेक्स्ट बॉक्स इट शुड चेंज द कलर. व्हाट इज इट कैसा नो.
यस सर वी कैन चेंज क्लास ऑन होवर.
No, as of now, I'm not talking about the class. I'm saying color, color. Are you with me or not? Color.
Mouse color.
Not mouse color. See this one. So now, so far, the style which you know is, so far, the style which you all know is, style equals to, S-T-Y-L-E, style equals to, say, background color, right? Background color which you all know style which you all know is background color. I say white, 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 correct team. And the color means text color, I'm saying black. So this is what happening. See here, so it's always going to be background is white and text color is black. Okay, what I want is the moment it hovers, I want color should be changed dynamically, right? So what I will, you know, what I will do is I will apply the colors dynamically. Sorry, I will apply the style dynamically. Correct. Again, I need a functionality. So you tell me what directive. When I say again, I need a functionality means obviously directive need to be applied. Which directive I can use or which directive I would be using? Because I wanted to play with style, that is why ng style. Is that clear or not?
Yes, yes.
But now just you know, be with me team and pay attention. It is little advanced, not too much advanced, but little one step ahead. What I want is, I want the moment, you know, I hover on the text box, correct? My style should apply dynamically. What style should apply dynamically? I say my ng style is directive. I say ng style equals to double quotes and I want to apply my style. I say in the style, I would say background, right? Background, R-O-U-N-D, R-O, G-R-O-U-N-D, background hyphen color. Color colon. Now I want to apply. I say yellow. Okay, I say yellow, like this. But this I want to apply on some condition. This I want to apply on some condition. You got my point? So, but where is the condition? For condition, I need a variable. I need a class variable. I need a property in short, right? I need property in short. So what will happen in this case is, because there is no condition, because you don't have any condition. So what is going to happen is, so style is automatically added. Okay. The style is automatically added, not on the hover. You got my point, team? Yes or no?
Style, yes, sir.
Will be automatically added, but not conditionally. So let's add a condition. So what I do is I will go into login and create one variable. Say, for example, is hovered. So is hovered. That is how we create variables. okay, is hovered, so that by looking at the variable, looking at the property, you will understand it's a number type or it's string type or it is boolean type or it is date type. So it is boolean type, and by default value is false. Correct? By default value is false. Or you can, you know, put this false in the constructor. That will be the better place. In the constructor only, you know, the class properties will define, will initialize with the default value. So boolean default value is always false. And now I'm saying, when you hover, please pay attention here. When you hover, then I'm saying, it should be true. And when I hover out, means mouse leave, then I'm saying it should be again false. Do you agree on this or not?
Yes.
You all?
Yes.
But how to use this variable?
Yes.
Now we take this variable, we come back to ng style, and here I will say apply background color, correct? When is hovered, right? One second. Is hovered is equals to true. If that is so, have you used ternary operator in your life? Did you know any ternary
yes.
operator in your life? Ternary. I mean, you might be knowing it, but others, you know, ternary operator. So this is like inline if else. You consider this like inline if else. So I'm saying, please pay attention here. So it says, is hovered equal to true? If that is true, question mark is if it is true. Team, question mark means if this is true. What is true? Is hovered equal to true? If this is true. If is hovered is true only, then you apply yellow color. Otherwise, this colon is else, you apply white color. Do you got my point or not?
Yes, sir.
Is hovered equal to true? Question mark. Question mark means if the before statement is true, then you do this. What do you do? Pass yellow. You are passing yellow to where? You're passing yellow to background color. Else, colon means else. Else you pass white. What white? You pass white color. I mean, white color is going to pass in the background color. Let's see this works or not. So I hover, not working. Hover out. Okay, still the same. It's working.
File save.
No, it's working. But it is. The moment you type something and then you do it, it's working. Yeah, it's working. Okay. Right? Correct, team?
Yes, sir.
It's all working. So same thing you can apply to password as well. Correct? This mouse hover and leave, both the events will work on the password also, and the style condition will work on the password also, right? Saved it. Let's go back and make this one empty first of all. See? One second. By it is making, you know, see, obviously it will happen. See, it is making hover. It is making both hard. I mean, it is applying hover on both. Why? Because the variable is same that we've used. Did you notice? The variable which we have used are two. Oh, sorry, it is one. Same variable is applying. Correct, team? So, can I say, can I make two variable? Unnecessary, I'm stretching this, but it's okay, it's worth it. So I say is hovered is UNA hovered. And next one is TWD Howard, okay? Write him. And yes. I will make both of them as false. And then what I will do is, okay, so I need to do little tweak. Say I will pass UNA. Say PWD, or I say P U and U. Okay. Here I would say type. Okay. So here I will say if type equals to U. If that is so, then that means UNA is Howard, correct him? UNA is Howard and PWD will be false. Do you agree or not?
Yes.
Else type is equals to P, which means now password is Howard, so I make it this true and I'll make this as false. Right?
Yes, sir.
Correct? Kya problem hai? Expected? What expected?
Else में condition नहीं आती है. Else doesn't have a condition.
Ah, correct. When I say else, so like this, else. So previously I was applying if else. So because there is only one condition, so it was saying if is not applicable. Yeah. So like this is fine. Now, the same thing. You apply for mouse out also. So if your type is type, so if type type, yeah. So if type is U, then UNA Howard, you make it false. But I'm not sure this is Howard or not. And else, as if type equals to say U, and you, after U we have P. If type equals to P, then I would say Rudy Howard equals to false. Let's see, this works or not. It's not saved or what? Oh, so variables. So here we will use and here we'll use PWD Howard. Correct him? was the issue. Yes. So let's see now. Okay, so this is working. When I click here, mouse over here. Correct? Here. Working, right? See? Cross also it's working. Did you see that?
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes.
So this is how you can make the form quickly. So what I'm trying to portray over here, it's very easy, very simple, right? You just need to apply property events with, I mean, if you play with them, in short, they're all directives if you see. So if you understood this, then you can apply any kind of logic, right? And the logic which I applied, I'm 100% sure you can apply better than this. I have used two variables. I'm sure if you pay attention or invest more time, you will be able to do the same thing with one variable. You got my point?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay.
Yes. Okay. Sir.
So this is like event binding what we did. Okay, event binding. Same kind of event binding you can directly apply on anywhere. It's not like you need to have a form where you will be applying this event binding. You can apply in your student list also. The same student list which you worked on. Right, let me just show it to you. So let me open app.component.html. And again, let me just go back to the student. Right, student. Correct team, and let me say close others. Let me open students and HTML and bifurcate the file. And here, let me open the TS. Yeah. So here you see we have. I'm just removing this hidden. And just commenting it here so that you can apply it later. So I have this list, okay? And we have four students basically. Good. We have four students. First of all, let's see, is it working or not? Then we apply our event binding here. Yeah, it's working. It's working, right? So let me put some styles. Okay, leave it. Let's focus on what we're supposed to do. Okay. So what I want is now you tell me. You want a whole row should be clickable, or you want only the name should be clickable? How you want it to, how you want it to be? Team, you want the whole row should be clickable, or you want only the particular column should be clickable.
I think just the name.
Yeah. So you're saying only name, right? So let's see, this is a typical grid and I want the name should be, clickable. And what I want is my client requirement is when you click on, let's say name, the alert or the model pop-up should open and give the complete information about the user. So when I say complete information, maybe what I'm trying to say is address. And address again has some property, says leave, this will be like too much for you. I'm saying city. सिटी स्टेट स्टेट इज DELH दिल्ली then COUNT or a country INT city say BLR Bangalore you know I belongs to Bangalore anyone of you who belongs to Bangalore or South India
no sir
You all are from Northern India?
Yes.
Every one of you? HYD, Hyderabad. This comes under Telangana. So what my requirement client requirement is when you click on let's say the name it should show the complete information or required information of my user do you all agree or not
yes
sir
let's try to make something like this okay hold on Let me add. You all are aware of anchor tag?
Yes.
Are you all aware of anchor tag? What basically anchor tag does?
Creates hyperlinks.
It converts the text into links. So if it
click into links. Yes. That's a perfect definition. Anchor tag. So I am using it not to redirect to anywhere. I'm using this anchor tag just to show this name like a link okay I don't want to redirect to anywhere so that's why I'm saying javascript okay void you know what it is what does that mean
no sir
Right? Null and void. You getting my point? Usually, in href, what we used to write?
Links. Some link where we want to redirect that particular.
Exactly. Got my point? Like this. Correct? So that is what href does in anchor tag. So I want. Don't do anything. Okay. And I just wanted to apply my event here. Which event? I say click event. Correct. And what this click event will do? It will have, of course, a handler. Which handler? FETH fetch or get. Get user. Right? Get user info, I would say. Or get user handler. That's the best name. Always give a good naming convention to your method. Here you pass I. If I pass I here, will that be good enough? Or no? Team, when I pass I here, will this be good enough or not?
No, I
means what? Again, see here. I means what? I is an iterator. Who is iterating each and every element? Who is iterating through each and every element? Of students so I first time I will be pointing to this object second time I will be pointing to Ajay object third time I will be pointing to Deepa object and fourth time I will be pointing to Ruhi object right so I'm doing the same thing I'm saying the moment I will be pointing to and if you click then you pass the I which means I am passing the entire object to my function now you agree or not
yes
passing I means I am passing the entire object instead of loose properties like name, comma, username, comma, role number, comma, program, comma, city, comma, state, comma, country. I am passing the entire object. Team, do you agree or not?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
I don't think you agree or agree with me. Do you all agree? Let me just call out the names.
Yes,
so Arjun, Ankit, Sandeep, Ayush, Mukta.
Yes, sir.
Vishal.
Yes, sir.
You all agree, right? Good. So now I have this handler. Now I wanted to show the complete information. So first of all, let me just say Control K0. And let me here add a method, get user handler. And what it is expecting this time, it is expecting a complete object. So I say user, and again I don't know the type of it, so I say any, because user has username, phone number, city, you know, program, role number, everything. So I don't know the type, so I put any. Okay, and here you can simply say alert. First of all, let me just put console log and show it to you. Is it printing or not? So I say user. On click, is it throwing the right info or not? Save. Keep looking at the console. Okay, I click on Ajay, so it is showing the Ajay's object. I click on Ruhi, it is giving me Ruhi's object, right? I click on, let's say, Deepa, it is giving me Deepa's object. Tim, did you see that or not? Right? Correct? Yes, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now I wanted to print it. I wanted to print it. So what I will do is, on top of this, I create one div, and the div I say label. Please go on mute. Team. Please go on mute. Yeah. Name. Name, and the place of name I will say strong. I don't have the object as of now. I'm just creating the skeleton first, HTML skeleton. So in the first paragraph I'm going to print the name, and my second paragraph p tag I'm going to print the address. Okay, so to print this, what I will do now is I will create one object, say user, again of any type. I'll create one class property. Again, let's be specific. I'm creating one class property called user and initializing it in the constructor and saying my user, this dot user should be null. It's an object, empty object. As of now, I don't know. It's an empty object. And now, what I will do is, team, if any time you see you're not getting it, please raise your hand or speak up immediately. Okay? Don't say yes or think that, you know, we'll do it later after watching the video. No. You might see the video because of the content or because of the syntax, but the concept should be clear, you know, now only. So what I did is I created one class property, right, which I call object. How you define it's an object, because it's any as of now, first point. Second point, if you see in the constructor, I define it with curly braces. I declare it with curly braces. Curly braces means object. If I say square bracket, means array. Right, team? If I say square bracket, means uses an array. If I say curly braces, it's a object. If I say single quote, it's a string. If I kept it single quote, it's a string. If I say zero, it's a number.
Number.
If I say new date time, it's a date time. Correct?
Yes.
I say curly braces. So it's an object, which means it holds more than one property. So I'll go here and instead of this, because so that you will not get confused, I say you. And here also say you. And here I say this dot user equals to you. Make sense? And here in the HTML, I will say simple thing. I say user dot, of course in curly braces, interpolant, user dot name, correct? And here I would say user dot city comma state comma country country. Okay, and so see, name and address is printing. Did you see that? Name and address is printing in advance, which is not correct way. Let's first of all see, is it filling or not? Deepa, yes, it is showing. Ajay, yes, it is showing. Again, I cling on Deepa. Yes, it is again changing the address to Hyderabad. I am clinging on Vinay. It says New Delhi. Correct, perfect. It says, if I say Ruhi, yes, it is giving the right information. But did you notice when I refresh, I didn't click anywhere and the skeleton, right, is printing. Is it a correct way to handle it or not?
No, sir.
Obviously no. So when you want this div to load, when you want this div to load,
when we click on some object,
be more precise. Why this div is empty, these things are empty on load, because user don't have anything. User object is empty, correct?
Right.
So when exactly you are supposed to show or load this div? Team, question to all of you.
When we click on the link, then it is supposed to be loaded.
Which means, see, you are telling me the process. I'm asking you the precise answer. Why this div is empty? Because user is empty. Agree or not? Because user object is empty on the load. User will only get populated when I click on any of the row. So what is the reason of, again, same question. What is the reason of this div to show the empty skeleton, not the value? Because user is empty. User object is empty. So can't I put a check? Did I show you ng if before?
No.
So let's try the condition. Asterisk ng if, again, I need a functionality, which means I need directive. I say ng if, you show me this div, ng if user, right? If user, correct, is equals to true. True means have some value. See, now the div is not loading. Why div is not loading? Because this if condition is false actually. Why it is false? Because user is not true. Now you will say user is not a boolean, why are you checking true and false? So with object, when you say true and false, we are talking about the object is empty or not empty. You getting my point? With object also, we can apply true and false correct? So if you apply true and false, if you check true and false with object, so what it will check? The object is empty or not empty. So when you load, my object is empty. That is why this condition is false. What it says, ng if means you exist, you will come into picture only when user is true, means when user has some value or data. As of now, user is false. So this condition is false. If this condition is false, this div is not going to load. Now the other situation, if I click here, correct? Now also it is not loading. Very good. So let me, instead of typing like this, true, I check this.
Sir, we can pass if user is equal to not null.
Then let's do one thing. One second. Then here you pass null. This will be a better way to handle it. Okay. Now we can check with null. If user is not null, not equals to null. User not equals to null. Let's see this now. Yeah, now it's fine. I repeat one more time. Now you see, your div is not loading because your user is null initially. Initially, a user object is null. Correct, team? Your user object is null. Because user is null, that is why this div is not loading. Why? Because in the condition, what you have written is show me. Ng if means show. Show only when user is not null. But in the initial case, when it loads, user is null. That's why this div is not loading. And the moment, you know, we are getting data in the user, this div is loading because it is not null. Will that make sense? If I click on Ajay, it is showing me the Ajay's data. Does it make sense, team?
Yes.
Is it all good for all of you, or it's like too much for you? Tell me. You understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. No problem. Do we have Arushi in the call? No. Okay. No problem. So, okay, I guess that's it. If I do more, then it will be like too much, right? So let's end the session at this point. And again, apart from Abhilasha and Arjun, everyone else is able to see the recording the moment, you know, our recording off or class off.
Yes.
Correct, nah? So only Arjun and Abhilasha, these two people are not able to access the recording. So we'll still figuring out, you know, Arjun and Abhilasha. I mean, point is not able to, you know, identify why it is happening to you only. So that is why what I did is I created a YouTube channel where I'm uploading all the videos. Okay. So all the videos till now is uploaded in the channel. I have mentioned the, you know, link also in the group. Correct. So this one also in 10 minutes, it comes to me. 15 minutes it takes to download, and then upload takes 5 minutes. So in next 1 hour, you will find the video in the YouTube. Correct. But in next 5 minutes, you will again have the video in the team channel. So please, Arjun, check one more time. If you're not able to get, anyways, you will get it in the YouTube channel. Okay. So now I guess Mukta, since you understood, yes, how to resolve the error, so I guess you first resolve your error, and I guess you will be able to finish or practice what we did today. Okay. Team, yes. One simple notice: if you guys don't practice what we did today, then in next session you will be 100% not able to understand what we are doing. You getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Not 100%, 201% sure. Okay, So condition applies here. Please practice whatever we have done so far. And when I say practice means understand. Just don't just run the program. Okay. Please don't just run the program. Practice it. Okay. Practice it. Understand it basically. What we are doing, why we are doing. Come up with your doubts tomorrow. Okay.
सर एक चीज क्या प्रॉब्लम कर सकते हैं कंपोनेंट को सर डिलीट किया जा सकता है
हां क्यों नहीं मतलब तुम सपोज व्हाट यू आर सेइंग इज तुम किसी कंपोनेंट को डिलीट करना चाह रहे हो राइट करेक्ट
यस
हेलो हां सो यहां से यहां पर जाओ या मुझे स्टूडेंट को डिलीट करना है राइट क्लिक किया इसे डिलीट कर दो लेकिन जब यहाँ से डिलीट करोगे तो इसकी एंट्री कहाँ पर हो रखी है मुक्ता हर कंपोनेंट की हर एक आइटम की एंट्री कहाँ होती है ऐप मॉड्यूल में राइट ऐप मॉड्यूल में तुम्हें ऐप मॉड्यूल से भी स्टूडेंट हटाना पड़ेगा समझे
तो वहाँ मैनुअली करना पड़ेगा मतलब दो से डिलीट
कोई इशू नहीं है यहाँ से जाओ हटा दो ये हटाओगे तो ऊपर जो स्टूडेंट तुमने यहाँ इंपोर्ट किया ये हटा दो सेकंड स्टेप थर्ड स्टेप गो एंड डिलीट द स्टूडेंट फोल्डर डन राइट
ओके सर
एंड ऑफ कोर्स फोर्थ स्टेप जहां जहां तुम स्टूडेंट कंपोनेंट को कॉल कर रहे हो विच इज योर ऐप कंपोनेंट हेयर यहां से हटा देना ठीक है
ओके सर
Okay, so see you tomorrow with all this practice, correct? Please see, as I said, you have to do this, then only you will understand what is going to happen tomorrow. Else you will be left behind. Pakka, 100%. Chhod jayega tomorrow. Okay? Right? So let's call off the session for today and see you tomorrow. Bye, team.
Okay.